Hello friends, this is Nirmal here for Technique, and in this video we'll share some of the hidden tips and tricks on the Xiaomi Mi3 running the Android KitKat 4.4 and also the MIUI version 5.0. So this is a really high-end smartphone which comes with really great hardware and excellent software to support it. So that's the MIUI from Xiaomi. So we'll share some of the tips and tricks you can perform on this device. Some of these tips and tricks are like hidden, that they are not available directly to the user, while some of them are available from the settings. So let's start off the tips and tricks, so starting from the lock screen. So when you open the lock screen, you can see the option to unlock it. Now here we have few things. So if you press and hold the home button here, so this will enable the torch. So you can see the torch is enabled, and you can see the screen has now the torch icon and the ability to switch the torch off. So that's pretty handy option to have. So if you want to use the phone as a torch, you just have to press and hold the home screen button and it will enable the torch, and then you can use it from there. So another pretty useful option on the lock screen is the music player. So if you double tap the lock icon, you can see that it will show you the music player. So you can quickly switch on the music from the lock screen instead of having to open the app and then play the music. You can just directly play the music from here, and again double tap, it will take you back to the lock screen. So that's two steps we can have on the lock screen. Now we can change quite a lot of options here. So just press and hold in any vacant area, and you can see you have the options, a lot of options available here. So these are to move apps, you have the support for widgets. So there are quite a lot of widgets available. So you can see you can customize your home screen with tons of widgets available. Along with that, you can customize with wallpapers. So you can select whichever wallpaper you want. You can even pick wallpapers from online option. Then there is FX. So you can see here, you can select the FX which you want to happen when you switch between the home screen. So that's again there present there. So that's a pretty handy tool on the home screen. Next up, we'll talk about the notification. So generally, if you want to access the notification, you swipe from the top of the screen and you access the notification. But on MIUI, you don't have to swipe from the top. You can just swipe from the half of the screen, and then you can still access the notification. We'll just show you once again. So you can see, I just swipe from the center of the screen or even at the bottom of the screen, and it will pull out the notification. So that's pretty handy. If you want to quickly access the notification, just swipe somewhere on the screen and it will pull down the notification. This feature is also available in Amigo UI, which we saw on the Xiaomi phones. Now the notification center, you can do quite a lot of customization here with the quick launch icons. So you can see the more option here. From the more option, you can actually have a customized look of your quick launch icon. So you can see here there are quite a lot of options available, and you can select whichever options you want, like network, a screenshot, guest mode, torch. You can select hotspot and other options. So first 11 options included in this list will be available in the notification center. So that's pretty handy again. Next up, we'll talk about the multitasking option on this phone. So generally, if you see the multitasking option on most Android phones, if you press the options only, you can see the thumbnails of all the active windows. But here you have a different one, so you can just press and hold this option and you can see the multitasking window. So this is the multitasking window, and you can see here the icons are listed here. That means these are the apps running right now. And you can see here you have the quick option to release the memory and clear all the recent apps. So if you don't want a particular app to be cleared here, so you can just say, for example, if you don't want to clear the Gmail, you can just pull it down and it will be locked. So you can see here small icon available close to the Gmail icon. That means this app is locked and it will not be removed from the recent list, in even if you click this clean button. So this is one touch clean button. So just press it and you can see it will clear the memory and the cache, and you will get more memory for your phone, and the memory occupied by the apps are cleared from here. So you can just unlock apps if you want. So if you just press and hold this area, and then you can see the locked apps. So these apps will always be running in the background. So if you just pull it from here, so this will be like released now. Now once again, if I press, all the apps will be removed from here. So that's the option to lock apps which are not to be cleared. Now another handy option on the home screen is that you can just flip an app to show it in minimalistic mode. So just this feature is not available for all apps. We just saw this feature only on two of the apps available. So one was the music player. So if you please flip the icon from here, you can see it will pop up the music player and you can play songs from here. So once you're done, just press anywhere and the music player will flip back. The same goes with the notes. You can just flip from here, you can see the notes application which is just available here. And then when you press here, it will just flip back to the original position. This is not exactly the app running in full screen, but instead it will just pop up the app, and then you can quickly take notes or you can quickly switch music. This is available only in these two apps. We couldn't find this option available in other apps. Another important app in this phone is a security app. So you can see here, security app has quite a lot of options, and one of the most important app sets available here. So first up, you can check the security options to see how good the phone is performing, and you can see here it will suggest you other options to make the security, make the phone better in security. So you can just click the optimize button and improve the security of the phone. And along with the security option, you can see here there are few other options available here listed below. One is the cleaner. So cleaner is basically which cleans the cache file, the add files, packages and all the residual files which are occupying your storage space. So you can click the scan button, and then it'll search for all the junk files. These are basically junk files which are not being used, which are still lying on your phone, most probably the cache, the add files, the packages and other residual folders files. So you can just click one button clean. One click clean is available here. So the second option here is the data usage. So that's self-explanatory, and you can set the data limit per month, and whenever it goes beyond that limit, it will stop the cut off the data usage, and it will save monthly bills for you. And whenever you have selected this option, you can see here at the bottom in the notification center, you can see the amount of data being consumed on a daily basis. So you can see here the monthly limit is 2 GB, and 1.3 GB is right now available, and it also shows the usage which happened today. So that will be available only if you have the data usage option turned on. And then you have the block list. So block list is again self-explanatory. That means you can block messages and calls from particular person. Say if some telemarketing team is like disturbing you, then you can just add them into the block list, and their phones, when their calls and messages will be blocked on your phone. Then you also have the power mode here. Power mode is again the battery consumption, and the option to schedule battery usage. So you can see the battery consumption. So you can see here the default, then the marathon is there. Marathon means it will disable Wi-Fi and also the data usage. Then sleep, all the network functions like calls, messaging, all are disabled except for the alarm clock. So these are the options. So you can enable the scheduling of these modes from here. So that's the power mode. Then you can also see the power usage, and apps and hardware which are using the power the most can be found from here. Then you also have a virus scanner here. So that's a handy option in case you find your browsing, while browsing you encounter with some virus, you can just clean it using from here. You can just perform a scan, and the app will actually scan your phone and find out if there are any threats for your phone. So that's again a very handy option. The final option is the permissions. So you can see here it has an option to select which all apps can auto start with your phone. So right now you can see here Hangouts, WhatsApp and Gmail are available for auto start. That means whenever you boot the phone, these apps will automatically be started, and you can also add apps to that list. So if you want a particular app to be auto started with the phone boot, then you can add it from here. Apart from that, you can manage app permissions which all apps can access particular features on your phone that can be managed from here. So this set of options is available all under the security tab. So you can select whatever options you want based on your preferences. So there are lots of other customization options as well. So we'll talk about the other tips and tricks in our second video, because there are lots of more tips and tricks coming up. So stay tuned. This is the first part of the hidden tips and tricks on the Xiaomi Mi3 running the MIUI with Android 4.4 KitKat. So stay tuned for the second video, where we'll show up more features, more options, customization options and lot more. So that's all guys. If you have any specific queries regarding this, drop a comment and we'll be glad to help you out with your queries. If you like this video, do hit the like button, subscribe to YouTube channel for more updates, and thanks for watching this video.